Hi, welcome back to machine learning tutorial. In this video, we will understand how to find entropy, information gain, Gini index. Based on information gain and Gini index, how to select a splitting attribute given a data set. In this case, we have been given a data set with 9 examples and there are two classes are there. The one class is positive class and another class is negative here, and there are three attributes A1, A2 and A3 here. So first we'll try to understand how to find the entropy of this particular data set. Entropy of S is always equivalent to minus summation of pi log pi to the base 2, where pi is the probability of ith class in this case. If you look at this particular data set, we have 9 examples. Out of that, 4 are positive and 5 are negative examples. Hence, the entropy of S is equivalent to minus 4 by 9, that is the probability of positive examples, log 4 by 9 to the base 2, minus 5 by 9, log 5 by 9 to the base 2, where 5 by 9 is the probability of negative examples. If you solve this equation, you will get the entropy as 0.9911 in this case. Here, if you want to know how to find the logarithm with base 2, you can use this equation, that is log of a to the base 2, that is equivalent to logarithm of a divided by logarithm of 2. So this is the equation you can use to find the logarithm with any value the base is equivalent to 2 in that case. So we understood how to find the entropy here. Now we try to find the information gain of attribute A1 here. In this case, A1 has two possibilities. One is true and another one is false in this case. So first we need to find the entropy of true examples and entropy of false examples. We have already calculated the entropy of whole data set. So considering these three, we can calculate the information gain of A1 here. So we know that the entropy formula is minus summation of pi log pi to the base 2. The entropy of the data set where the A1 is equivalent to true is always equivalent to minus 3 by 4. That is, if you consider, there are 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 true examples are there. Out of that, 1, 2 and 3 are positive examples and 1 is negative example. So the probability of positive examples within true, that is 3 by 4, log 3 by 4 to the base 2, minus negative examples, this is the only negative example we have here, that is 1 by 4, log 1 by 4 to the base 2. And if you solve this equation, you will get the entropy of true examples is 0.811. Similarly, we need to find the entropy of false examples. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 false examples are there. So out of 5 false examples, you can see here, this is the positive example, negative, negative, negative and negative. So 1 is positive and the remaining 4 are negative examples here. So the entropy of SF, that is the data set when the false examples are there, which is equivalent to minus 1 by 5. That is 1 positive example is there out of 5. Log 1 by 5 to the base 2 minus 4 negative examples are there. So 4 by 5 log 4 by 5 to the base 2 here. And if you solve it, you will get the entropy of false examples is 0.722. Now using these two and the entropy of whole data set, we can calculate the information gain of A1 here. That is, the gain of A1 is always equivalent to the entropy of whole data set minus the entropy of individual data sets should be multiplied by their the proportionate values. That is, the proportionate values, proportionate true examples multiplied by entropy of true examples, proportionate false examples multiplied by entropy of false examples. That is equivalent to entropy of S as it is minus 4 by 9. That is, there are 4 true examples are there out of 9. That is 4 by 9 here. Entropy of the true examples minus 5 by 9, that is proportionate of false examples multiplied by entropy of false examples. Put all the values in this particular equation, you will get the entropy is equivalent to, that is sorry, the information gain is equivalent to 0.2295 in this case. So the information gain of A1 is equal to 0.2295. Similarly, we will try to identify or find the information gain of A2 here. Again, we need to find the entropy of possible values of A2. There are two possible values, again true and false. Now, the entropy of true examples is, there are 5 true examples are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out of 5, you can see here, the first and second one are true, and the remaining 1, 2 and 3 are negative examples here. Okay, so you can say that minus 2 by 5 log 2 by 5 to the base 2, that is positive examples, minus 3 by 5 log 3 by 5 to the base 2, that is negative examples. And if you solve it, you will get the entropy as 0.9709. Similarly, we will calculate the entropy of false examples. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 false examples are there. Out of that, first one is negative, second one is positive, third one is negative, and fourth one is positive. So, 2 positive and 2 negative examples are there. So, entropy is equal to minus 2 by 4 log 2 by 4 to the base 2, minus 2 by 4 log 2 by 4 to the base 2. And if you solve it, you will get the entropy as 1.0. Now, we will use the gain formulae to calculate the gain of A2 here. The gain of A2 is equal to entropy of whole data set minus proportionate of positive examples, that's the proportionate of true examples, entropy of true, minus proportionate of false examples, entropy of false examples. So, that is what is written here. So, V is equal to either true and false in this case. That is entropy of S minus 5 by 9. That is 5 times true examples are there out of 9, entropy of true example. 4 times false examples are there, so 4 by 9 entropy of false here. Put all the values, you will get the gain as 0.0072 in this case. So, gain of A2 is 0.0072. Now, we will try to find the Gini index of these two attributes, that is A1 and A2. So, before you calculate the Gini index, first you need to calculate the Gini of those particular attributes, and then you can go ahead with the Gini index. So, Gini is always equal to 1 minus summation of pi square, where pi is the probability of ith class class in that case. Now, Gini of t, first we'll try to calculate the Gini of true examples only, and then we calculate the Gini of false examples, and then we will go with the Gini index. So, Gini of true examples is equal to 1 minus, so there are totally 4 true examples are there, you can see here. Out of 4, 1, 2 and 3 are the positive, and this is the only negative example we have here. So, 1 minus 3 by 4, that is the probability of positive examples, minus 1 by 4, that is probability of negative examples, which is equal to 0.375. Similarly, we will try to find the Gini of false examples, that is 1 minus probability of positive examples minus probability of negative examples within false. So, totally we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 false examples are there. Out of that, 1 is true and remaining all are, 1 is positive and remaining all are negative examples here. So, 1 minus 1 by 5, that is probability of positive examples, minus 4 by 5, that is probability of negative examples. And if you solve it, you will get 0.32 as the answer in this case. So, once you calculate the Gini of true and false, now we need to calculate the Gini index. The Gini index of A1 is equal to the proportionate of true examples multiplied by Gini of true examples plus proportionate of false examples multiplied by Gini of false examples here. That is 4 by 9, that is 4 times true examples are there out of 9, Gini of true. 5 false examples are there, that is 5 by 9 multiplied by Gini of F in this case. Put all the values what you have calculated in the previous step, you will get the Gini index of A1 is equal to 0.3444 in this case. Similarly, we try to calculate the Gini index of A2. Before that, we need to calculate the Gini of true and false, because A2 also has the two possibilities, true and false in this case. So, Gini of true is equal to 1 minus the proportionate of positive and negative examples within true examples. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 true examples are there. Out of that 1, 2 are positive. Remaining 3, 1, 2, 3 are negative here. So 1 minus 2 by 5 bracket square, that is the proportionate of positive examples, minus 3 by 5 bracket square, that is the proportion of negative examples, which is equivalent to 0.48. Similarly, Gini of F, which is equivalent to 1 minus, first we need to know how many false examples are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 false examples are there. First one is negative, second one is positive, third one is negative, fourth one is positive. So 2 are positive, 2 are negative. Hence 1 minus 2 by 4 bracket square minus 2 by 5 bracket square, which is equivalent to 0.5 in this case. So finally, the Gini index of A2 is equivalent to the proportionate of true examples multiplied by Gini index of Gini of true plus the proportionate of false examples multiplied by the Gini of false here. So put all the values which is calculated in the previous step, you will get the Gini index of A2 is equivalent to 0.4889 in this case. So we understood how to calculate the entropy, how to calculate the gain of A1 and A2, as well as Gini index of A1 and A2. Now we need to understand how to select the splitting attribute based on these things. Now we know that the gain of A1 is equivalent to 0.2295, that is calculated in the previous step. The gain of A2 is equivalent to 0.0072. In this case, the gain of A1 is more than the gain of A2. Hence, you can say that the attribute A1 is selected as the splitting attribute in this case. Coming back to Gini index, the Gini index of A1 is equivalent to 0.3444 and the Gini index of A2 is equivalent to 0.4889 in this case. The smaller the Gini index, better the splitting attribute. Hence, in this case, we select A1 as the splitting attribute. So when you consider gain, the gain should be as high as possible to become a splitting attribute. And when you consider Gini index, the Gini index should be as small as possible so that you can consider it as a splitting attribute. So in this case, A1 has the small Gini index. So we select A1 as a splitting attribute here. So in this video, we understood how can we calculate the entropy, information gain, Gini index, and how to select a splitting attribute based on information gain and Gini index. I hope the concept is clear. If you have any other questions, you can put those questions in the comment box so that I can answer those questions at the earliest. If you like the video, do like and share the video with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.